Steve Andrews is giving a voice to the voiceless and taking the powerful to task. Now, 8 on Your Side investigates.
Hillsborough County is lining up sick and injured animals, turning them over to a nonprofit to dump on the streets, and all at your expense. It appears as though the Hillsborough County's animal shelter has its own version of quid pro quo.
The county has paid the Humane Society of Tampa Bay hundreds of thousands of dollars to take stray cats off its hands. What does the county get in return? Well, 8 on Your Side senior investigative reporter Steve Andrews now knows some of the answers.
Well, you know, one of the answers is the county looks great on paper. Its live release numbers keep going up. Its director of the Pet Resource Center keeps getting raises. It washes its hands of those cats, even the sick and injured ones. It's sticking in the program now. Gita is one of the lucky ones. She now lives in Mike McCall's Riverview home in the same subdivision where 2 years ago Mike found her lying on a street near death. He rushed her to a vet.
She has an eye infection, an upper respiratory infection, was really too young at that point to have been spayed.
Gita, a small kitten, had been left to fend for herself or die on the street as part of Hillsborough's Trap, Neuter, Vaccinate, and Release, TNVR program. The county pays the Humane Society of Tampa Bay more than 120 grand a year to, as seen in this video we shot in 2016, neuter, vaccinate, then release feral and stray cats the Pet Resource Center sends over.
Well, as a taxpayer, it's galling.
The PRC counts those cats as live releases. Director Scott Trebatoski's job performance evaluations and $143,000 a year salary are heavily dependent on him increasing the shelter's live release rate.
Some folks are not happy.
No, they're not. Earlier this week, we reported the PRC is now including 3-pound stray kittens in this program.
It's really, for a majority of the cats that go out, a really slow and torturous death.
According to PRC policy, a cat has to be in good health to be eligible for TNVR. But that's not happening. Records and rescues tell 8 on Your Side sick and injured cats are somehow ending up in the program.
He was not healthy when we pulled him.
Lauren Tillison rescued this cat from PRC in October when he weighed roughly 3 pounds.
Here on his sheet, it indicates that he has an eye condition and that it's infectious.
She also pulled his mother. PRC records noted no illness.
Their mother, when we received her, had a very high fever. She was not responsive.
According to CJ Paw's Animal Rescue, this cat has a permanent limp in a hind leg, is unable to run or jump, would not have lived long. PRC gave it a clean bill of health.
It seems to be mostly about the money. Let's get them out and away as cheaply as possible, and let's keep as many live release numbers as we can.
So now we know the Pet Resource Center is not following its own policy. It's sticking sick and injured animals in this trap, neuter, vaccinate, and release program. Hillsborough citizens have paid hundreds of thousands of dollars to the Humane Society of Tampa Bay to take these animals off the hands of PRC and dump them around the county. And as a result, that helps Scott Trebatoski to increase his live release rate, which in turn helps him keep his job and get pay raises.
A numbers game. What is the county's response?
Well, I reached out to the county twice again this week, requesting an interview with someone who can explain the changes in this program and the discrepancies that we've uncovered. I was told the director is the person who should answer my questions, and he is out of town.
All right, Steve. A follow-up to come, perhaps.
He'll be back eventually.
All right. If you have a problem you want Steve to investigate, you can call our 8 on Your Side helpline at 1-800-338-0808.